It's the 2K Sports Pregame Show.
With the Diesel and the Jet, this is Ernie Johnson. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. Tonight, we'll see the Golden State Warriors as they play against the Toronto Raptors. For Toronto, they've had a tough time over the last few weeks, 3-7 in their last 10 games. We'll see if they can make amends tonight. And the topic here prior to tip-off, so many teams in the league going up-tempo these days. Kenny, as a player, did you like that style? I'm assuming you had to love it.
Because the one thing about playing up-tempo, Ernie, it brings you back to the roots of the game, why you started playing. If you ever go to a pickup game, you ever go to a park game, no one's stopping play and calling plays. They're going up and down. The big fella Shaq, when he first came into the league, the first thing I saw was him grab the ball coast-to-coast in the All-American game. That's what players want to do and people want to see.
You know, that was a great example, Kenny, but towards the end of my career and most of my career, I was honestly more of a half-court player. I was pretty fast for my size, but my strength was my biggest edge. In the half court, barbecue chicken alert. I had to put that work in, Ernie.
That about wraps it up for here. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you again later.
That's the fifth barbecue chicken alert.
Being on some chips, 100. Real quick, they be on that rap to pay the bills, and I don't feel it, not even a little bit. Oh Lord, know yourself, know your worth. I been Steph Curry with the shot, been with the sauce, Chef Curry with the pot, boy. 360 with the wrist, boy. 0 to 100, real quick, real quick, real.
We've got basketball at Oracle Arena, the home of the Warriors in Oakland, California, live on 2K Sports. Looking at Toronto, they want to turn it around after the loss to Denver in the Rockies.
Yeah, look, they were able to keep it close for the most part, but you could just tell they were not in sync as a unit.
Greg, you're exactly right. It couldn't have been worse, in my opinion. They didn't look fresh at any point in the game. Just seemed to be flat and listless, no spark.
All right, let's set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Setting the floor for the Raptors. DeRozan at the two with Ross playing the three. Then there's Bell. Then it's Jordan. And it's Tinsley in at the power forward position. And here's Golden State. Tough loss coming against the Rockets in the last game they played.
It wasn't just about the bad shooting. It was really more so about the bad offense. They just didn't execute well. The screens weren't there. The spacing was poor, and thusly, the defeat.
Well, you've laid out a couple of the details that lead to good offense, or bad if you don't execute them. Shooting is just a byproduct of not screening well and not moving the ball or players well. They didn't execute anything on the offensive end.
For Toronto, they have been perfect at the line so far, albeit just 2 for 2.
Only shooting 71, really, on the season, so there is plenty of room for improvement.
And, Kevin, it's something they've been working very hard to correct in the change. I mean, they know how important it is to fix that inability at the free throw line.
Curry attacking. Here's Olynyk. The shot is off. So the Raptors will take it the other way. Rosen dishes to Bell. An absolute bomb from three-point range. Bell's got 7 points.
He can be a weapon if he gets going early from long range.
Shoots from the elbow, and it comes off the front of the rim.
Major defensive lapse right there. I mean, he's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. You've got to stay attached to him. They're lucky he couldn't punish them for it.
Now, here's DeRozan. 9 points last game out. And a wide-open look for Freak. Makes no mistake on the open jump shot. 9 points in the game so far. And here in the first, closing in on 2 minutes play. Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
Shot is off. Great D that time from Curry. Warriors have gone just 1 of 4 to get this game started. Here's Olynyk. Tries to keep it alive. And again, no good by Golden State.
and they're 1 of 5 to start this game. Just really haven't gotten into a flow offensively.
And DeRozan kicks to Bell. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. On its way from Curry for two. Here's Lyons, and Jordan sends it back. Bell against Curry. Parked down low that time, and he got the 3 second call.
And a chance here to see the numbers for free. Some good contributions, really, since the All-Star break. Right around 25 points per, 3 assists and 4 rebounds. And he brings that offensive firepower to the team. Scoring just comes naturally.
And, you know, defenses are throwing everything at him, yet he's still able to put up points. He's really unstoppable.
Curry gets the bucket.
He presents a defender with a serious challenge, always.
Curry against Bell. Here's the screen. Curry with the defensive effort.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
Here's Lyons. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Toronto leading by 3. Now let's find out what head coach Steve Curry had to say to Doris Burke. Doris?
Guys, he anticipates they'll be able to take advantage of the perimeter defense they're facing today and convert a lot of easy chances and uncontested looks from the outside. We'll see if they can knock them down, Kevin.
Thanks, Doris. Always want to get those threes falling consistently.
Yeah, Kevin, you're right, because that's really the only way that you can force the defense to spread out and extend itself. And when that happens, then other opportunities are created.
Just a great job of attacking on the break.
Yeah, you know, exploding to the basket like that, Greg, just as soon as that ball was going the other way, that's exactly how you want to do it. Well, that's inexcusable to throw a pass that far off the mark.
And the Raptors making a change here. Hill's checked in. Golden State's gone 0-2 from deep here. Clark, this offense has really been clicking.
No doubt about it, giving the defense all kinds of trouble.
And they know it, guys. They're playing right now with the kind of energy that is hard to deal with.
Back to Curry. Bogut at the elbow. 5 on the clock. This one for 3. Ross grabs the board.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
Bell passes to Hill. The feed now to Jordan. And the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
Yeah, just used his strength there to get the post position without much fight from the defense.
Yeah, I think he's got to do a much better job next time of just bodying up. Get some muscle into him.
Curry with another miss.
He's lost it in this quarter, no doubt about it. Nothing seems to be going for him.
And Bell kicks to Ross. Bell up on top, guarded by Curry. Mar DeRozan on the wing. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard.
And he can't. Off that screen, and the D just didn't get over the top of it.
Yep, weren't there in time enough to challenge, Greg, and when that's the case, you can mark those up for him.
Now, here's Thompson. It's a 5-point game. Curry attacking, and Jordan sends it back.
You know what? He's just stone cold right now. Really not sure if he's their best option offensively as they try to get back in this game.
Jordan the screen, pass to Ross. It's stolen by Bogut. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. And there's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. That one on DeRozan.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you. I mean, that's the message they were sending with that foul. Nothing easy inside.
Justin Holliday's checked in for the Warriors. Patrick Beverley comes in for Steph Curry. No good on the second free throw.
Tell you what, they haven't wasted any time getting into the swing of things on the boards.
And even this early, that's a good omen for the rest of the game.
Now, here's Beverley. He averages a bit over 6 points a game. Green, the screen. Holiday dishes to Iguodala. Off with the layup.
And he thought he had a clear path to the hoop, but the defense didn't give up on that play and cut him off.
And we reach the end of the first quarter. The Raptors out in front, leading by five. And don't go away. And DeAndre Jordan, not a focal point offensively for this team, but as a defender,
I'm not really a big scorer for our team, but that's not my job. My job is to defend and rebound for our team.
But Jordan, the man who knows what his job is. Troops going out now with a whole new group. Warriors trail by five. Setting the four for the Raptors. DeRozan at the two with Ross playing the three. Then there's DeAndre Jordan. Then there's Bell. And it's Tinsley in at the four spot. And Holiday kicks to Thompson. Dishes to Curry. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson. Curry's got five.
Very well executed pick to give him all kinds of space to get that one off.
Jordan, the screen. And here's Bell. 14 points from him the last game against Denver.
Back at you. I mean, they immediately get those 3 points back.
Trading spray guns from long range. Trading blows from behind the arc.
And it's slammed in by Holiday.
And then, guys, this game won't be close for long if they keep giving up dunks like that.
No, it won't, G.A. You're right. A glaring error defensively and letting him get all the way to the basket that time.
Well, it's only 2 points. I mean, it was flashy, no doubt, but still, it only counts for two. Two is all.
Wasted no time on that shot, but it's off the mark. Raptors leading by three. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with Doris Burke. Hey, Doris.
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Nuggets really delivered. He ended with 14 points, but also put up four boards. This was just the game he wanted to have as he leads his team to the playoffs. You want to be hot late, Kevin.
Doris, thank you. Well, guys, you know, he made play after play in that game.
Let's see if he can keep it going tonight. I say he does. I'll bet he goes off again.
That's a pretty bold prediction. I mean, he's going to have to be very, very strong to come close to dittoing that performance.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Dime-dropping delights is what I call it.
That is a nice pass. I will give you that one.
Yeah, he's on the money, that's no doubt. And the Warriors making a change here. Green's checked in. Cross on the wing. Out of bounds, Golden State takes possession.
I tell you what, that's just a major unforced error right there, guys. My goodness.
The Warriors trailing. Curry passes to Olynyk. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Curry's got his fifth assist in this one.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
Outside for Jordan. Out of bounds, Golden State takes possession.
And let's take a moment here to see some of the numbers for Draymond Green. Unbelievable play for him over the last month. He's averaging 11 points a game, 10 rebounds, and 4 assists. And he does the heavy lifting on the glass, throwing himself into the rebounding battle with just complete effort.
Sure is. I mean, he thinks every rebound is his, and most of them are. That's why he's putting up such big numbers.
You know what? Those are shots you just hate to miss when you get those kinds of bunnies on a possession.
Incredible timing on the alley-oop.
He absolutely hammered it down.
And guys, mark that play right there because that could be the one that leads to a surge to break this thing wide open.
There's the pick. Curry dishes to Thompson. It's good from long range. Thompson's got 5 points now this quarter. Toronto's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Bell against Curry.
Stick it too much.
Now Bell. 12 points for him. Just 5 to shoot. Ross with a wide open look. Tried to answer back, but that 3 is off the mark. Warriors have gone 7-16, shooting just under 50% here in the second quarter. Here's Curry, and the wide open shot from Green. Another 3 for Golden State.
Excellent feed from Steph Curry.
Raptors trail by 4. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game. And Ross with the slam.
How about that fantastic finish and the aggressive move, too, Kevin?
Trying to send a message, Clark, with that slam, I think.
And I'm not sure if it was text or email, but he definitely threw that one down.
Outside Curry. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot 2.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
Clearly a foul. I mean, didn't give him any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you've got to play without fouling.
The Warriors shooting their 4th and 5th shots at the foul line in the game.
And in terms of team numbers, the free throw percentage is right at 74.
Take a break. 2 shots.
And he makes the first. And the first half comes to a...
You guys had the lead after the first, but now find yourselves behind. What's the mindset of this team heading into the break?
I think we're still upbeat. We would like to have a stronger second quarter, but we know there's a lot of games left. Hopefully.
Quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. Freak really making a difference here.
And the approach of that first half was an aggressive one. Take it to the teeth of the defense, put them on the heels, and you're either going to score or get to the line.
And mostly he's been getting to the line, guys. I mean, he has the free throw total to show for it, as well as the bumps and bruises.
The Splash Brothers are the guards. Green is out there with the Linux, and it's Lyons in at the 3 spot. That's Steve Kerr's 5 as we get into the second half. And Bell kicks to Ross. And off the left side of the rim, and it swirls in for him. Ross has got 6 points.
And that's a nice possession. Did a good job to get that open shot.
On its way from Curry for 2. Again, Curry missing.
No other way to put it. Just a poor shooting performance for him. But luckily, his teammates have picked up the slack.
Warriors leading by 5. Lyons the pass to Kerr. A shot by Thompson and no one's around. The wing jumper off target. And it's the Raptors' ball. Last time they met was in Toronto.
And the last time these teams met, it was a walk in the park. And everybody got in on the act. Their bench was spectacular in that win.
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, the starters were extremely happy to get some rest and let the bench guys do the heavy lifting. Definitely a feel-good win for the team.
No good from Bell.
1 for 4 from the field since halftime. They're having a tough time getting it going here.
They get it back.
1 for 5 on offense. A slow start here in the second half.
Ross dishes to Bell. He kicks it to Tinsley. Let's the 3 fly, but they get it back. He dishes it to Bell. That's in there. Tinsley with the assist. 14 points for Freak. The Warriors have gone only 1 of 5 from the field since halftime. Very slow start offensively. It's Curry with the drive. It's hauled in by DeAndre Jordan. Raptors trail by 3. And Bell kicks to Tinsley. Olynyk with the steal. Here's Lyons. Plays it up and brings it in.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Clearly just an example of a different mindset between these teams.
Some of the leaders of the NBA, these point guards have been shooting lights out during the last month. Second, Stephen Curry.
Some remarkable shooters in that group. I mean, you know that when you're seeing those types of numbers at the point guard position, you're talking about some very intelligent and patient players.
In addition to being unbelievably gifted shooters, I mean, these guys have some of the smoothest, sweetest strokes in the NBA, which means they have some of the best strokes in the world.
And the basket by Olynyk.
You know, what an advantage he brings to this offense, guys. I mean, being able to drain the three ball, that really can spread a defense and extend the defense as well.
Count it, and the Warrior lead has been cut down to 3 points. Nice bucket there from Bell.
Watch out. Now that he's got his first three of the half, there might be more in store.
Curry kicks to Olynyk. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Curry's got assist number 10 tonight with that last one.
I love his shot selection today. He set the bar for the rest of the team.
Bell's shot is good.
As long as they keep spraying them from deep, we're going to have ourselves one exciting finish.
Yeah, it took them a while, but now they're starting to get into a flow from outside. And boy, is that time. And he's finally getting the feel from beyond. His second three of the half right there.
Pass to Ross. Jordan the screen, and for three, Bell. Warriors with the rebound. Green's got his third rebound on the night. Here's Thompson, and the layup is good after a nice lead pass. Now it's a 7-point Warrior lead.
And he is the ultimate when it comes to being a floor leader on the offensive end.
Yeah, you know, he's got a little bit of Greg Anthony in it, and he has been that leader today. I think he's done a really nice job of moving the ball and distributing it the way it needs to be done.
Well, Clark, I'm glad you referenced specifically why you thought he had a little Greg Anthony. I thought you were talking about the knees, my man. He looked a little hobbled out there for a moment.
Watch out.
And you can just see his confidence is rising bucket after bucket from long range.
Here's Curry. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
How about Steph Curry in this one? He's got 13 points and 11 dimes. He's given them a lot with his passing shots.
For Golden State, Kelly Olynyk checked in for Green, and it's Thompson in for Curry. Raptors trail by five. So for Toronto right now, Bell, he's in at the point. DeRozan out there with Hill. Then it's Corey Joseph, and it's Jordan in at the center position. The Warriors shooting about 42% so far. Iguodala, the pass to Beverly. And it's in after a nice bounce off the right side. Beverly's got the first points up on the board here in the fourth for the Warriors. Bell, that's a 2-point. And the rebound goes to the Warriors.
And if the shot's not there, you've got to understand that. Move the basketball.
Yeah, exactly. And I'm not quite sure what his mindset or what he was thinking there. I mean, that was just a terrible shot. Move it.
And Joseph kicks to Jordan. Thompson with the rebound. Warriors leading by seven. All sorts of time, and the Warriors tack on two more. Toronto, they've gone 0 of 3 to start the fourth quarter. Kicks it to Joseph. Back to Bell. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. Bell's got 27 points.
And just a step ahead of the D in that possession there, making the pass. Nice assist.
Here's Olynyk. Here's Beverly. Up and in on the way. And the Warriors lead by nine.
And the rebound and the follow show you what he is all about. Gritty and determined with a soft touch to match.
He's been on a tear from the three-point line this game.
And the foul called on Freak. That's foul number two for him.
Yeah, clearly he had an established position there.
Yeah, and I like this call because you want the refs in that situation. If there's any doubt, err on the side of giving the benefit of the doubt to the offensive player. That should have been a block, and it was.
The Raptors making a switch here. Tinsley's checked in, and it's blocked by Jordan. And that's out of bounds. Golden State will retain possession. Justin Holliday's checked in for Andre Iguodala. And Toronto also making a switch. Ross is checked in for Joseph. So it's the Warriors now. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. And Beverly kicks to Olynyk. And 2 free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. It's going to be on DeAndre Jordan. And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for the Warriors.
Boy, their passing has been picturesque, a thing of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
Couple that with just how well they've shot it from beyond, and they've made this thing look easy.
Really an extraordinary game for Olynyk. He has 14 points, and he has 1 steal to his credit as well.
And Clark, he's just done a great job defensively. That 1 steal doesn't tell the whole story.
And over 2.5 minutes in the books here in the fourth. They set the pick. Beverly dishes to Thompson. And Beverly kicks to Olynyk. And right through it goes. And the Warriors lead by 7. Toronto's gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. Jordan the pass to Bell. And a miss there on the triple. The Warriors have gone 4 of 8 in this fourth quarter, shooting an even 50% from the field. Beverly dishes to Holiday. Another 3 for Golden State.
Looks to me like they hit the refresh button here in the second half after shooting less than 40% from the field before the break.
But the defense allowed them to stay in it, and now with the offense looking rejuvenated, they've got to be feeling confident.
And the Warriors making a change here. Raptors trail by 10. And here's Bell from the arc. Raptors get it back. Out to DeRozan. Jordan the screen. DeRozan passes to Tinsley. Toronto working the ball around now. And again, no good by Toronto. Warriors leading by 10. It's Thompson off the drive. Again, Golden State.
And he could be the guy to put this game out of reach.
The Raptors have gotten only 3 of their 9 field goal attempts to go down since the end of the third. Pretty cold down the stretch. Golden State's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. And Beverly kicks to Green. And another 3 for Golden State.
And it looks like they left a defensive effort back in the locker room, guys. They just haven't had the same commitment here defensively in the second half.
And for 3, Bell. But they'll get another chance. And Tinsley kicks to Bell. That one's off, still out of sync.
And the shots just continue to say no in terms of falling.
Beverly with the ball. Now defended by Freak. Feeds to Thompson. Thompson is doubled. 6 to shoot. Beverly wide open. Off the mark there with the 3-point shot. Raptors trail by 15.
And guys, what we saw here tonight is one side having everything going for them. Huge margin of victory for the Warriors.
A few times this season, turnovers have cost them. But Clark, they really kept the ball under control.
I thought they were both focused and relentless, Kevin.
And so all the hard work here tonight converted into a tally in the win column. It'll be number 26 on the year.
And the game they played tonight, purposeful. They wanted to get after it after losing the first game of the year against these guys. Big boost of confidence for them to even up this season series against the Raptors.
And when you look back at this one, what an amazing performance this was for Curry. He just looked like an orchestrator out there. His teammates kept running to the open spot, and he found them time and time again.
Take a look at what Beverly's been doing. 9 points, and he's been delivering a healthy dose of helpers, too.
So we see the Warriors taking the game here.
How's that L feeling, Freak?
Yeah, you got it this time, man. We're going to get you next time, though.
Not happening, Freak. Keep dreaming, though. Hit me up when you get a chance. Got some stuff to talk to you about.
All right, we'll do. Hey, I'm serious. We're going to get you next time.
the 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Welcome back, Ernie Johnson, along with Shaq and Kenny the Jet. Let's quickly move forward now to the presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game, Stephen Curry. He came out of the locker room at halftime and was immediately on fire. That third quarter was his, and he did not hesitate to exert his will.
I will say this about Steph Curry. There is no player in the league more capable of single-handedly taking over a ball game than he is. What I mean is, Steph Curry's hot is hotter than anyone else is hot. He can beat you with his feet, his mind, his shot. The only thing you can be sure of is that he will beat you.
Well, he came to rescue the team tonight, Ernie. Things were getting desperate for him, and the consecutive losses kept mounting. But he put them on his back, and he responded.
And that'll do it for tonight. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and our illustrious 2K Sports...